There's a funeral home in Tampa that has been turning heads for decades, not because of what goes on inside the building, but rather because of what's clinging to the outside. In a place where lives are remembered, this creature has more than nine.
Drive by the Adams and Jennings Funeral Home on Nebraska Avenue in Tampa, and you'll see something that could have you take pause.
It's been around for so long, and people know it.
From afar, you'll see a white figure on the roof of the entrance. But get up close, and you'll discover the neighborhood icon, a white ceramic cat clinging to the side.
There's been people call us occasionally and think it's a live cat, and they want us to know that it's there.
And there's the cat. You can see the shadow of the cat.
So here's this cat's tale. The first of its nine lives started in the early 1950s, when it adorned what was a gift and antique shop.
It was placed on there for his wife. She liked cats, and she wanted a cat on the roof.
This feline is very familiar to Earl Polk. He was raised in this area and has worked for the funeral home on and off since 1971.
A lot of people grew up with the cat on the roof.
And when the funeral home took over what was the gift shop building in the 1960s, the cat stayed.
The cat was on the old building from the time we bought it.
And when the new building went up in 2008, the cat came with it.
When we moved to this building, the cat was taken down gently and professionally cleaned and then replaced. When we replaced the cat, we were going to have a ceremony, but people wanted up there so bad we did it kind of overnight, kind of got the cat back up there quick.
Curiosity has surrounded the funeral home cat, from news articles to social media.
People on Facebook have responded to pictures of it where they've asked, where is this cat? And everybody knew where it was at and what it was and who it belonged to.
At times, the cat has also provided a welcome distraction from the somber business taking place inside.
People come out to see the cat. In fact, we have people that come to the funeral home for a funeral, and they'll take their children outside to look at the cat and make sure the children know the cat's there and that they grew up with the cat, and now you're seeing the cat.
The funeral home has even put the cat on its business cards. And just in case you were wondering...
No, the cat's never had a name, no.
It may not have a name or any sign of life, but this funeral home cat has landed in the perfect resting place.
I think as long as it's a funeral home here, I think the cat will be there.
Oh, how about that?
That was scary.
We didn't need that close-up, did we? I do like how that part of the funeral home, I don't know what to call it architecture-wise, but it does kind of look like a witch's hat, like the cat.
Oh, on a witch's hat.
Yeah, now Earl tells us there may have originally been a black ceramic cat next to that white one on the gift shop, but he heard the owners took the black cat up north, and it shattered in the cold.
Ooh.
Happens to a lot of people who move up north.
By the way, that story was perfectly told.
I got to hand credit to producer Kristen Moore. She put all of those great cat puns in there for me.
Nice.